Hey there, I am Cami, creator of the blog Tidbits at tidbits-cami.com. I'm here to share all the details with you about our beautiful pull-down classroom maps that we installed in our homeschool room. Now, what actually started as a major DIY fail ended up to be pretty amazing. We really love having these maps for learning, and I do think they make a major design statement in this creative space. So I look forward to telling you all about them. Let me first give you a nice look at these two rolled down classroom maps. So first we have this world map with some darker, bolder colors. I love how it's made to look vintage, but does a really good job at visually separating the continents, the countries, the states, etc. So the labeling is detailed, but it's still very easy to find the places you are looking for. I feel like it is a beautiful and very educational piece of art. So then I also got a USA map. It's also a little distressed and muted to look slightly vintage. Now we like being able to take a closer look at the states and the countries and the counties and the cities and all the details in the country that we live in. It's been so great as my kids have been studying in history and geography this year. So behind the map, we actually installed a whiteboard, which is just so much fun for all of us. We simply got a sheet of whiteboard material from Home Depot and trimmed the edge with some wood trim and painted it. I do have a secondary education degree, and even though I'm not in a traditional school, this whiteboard and map combo sure makes me feel legit. The kids have had a lot of fun drawing and playing games on this board, and of course we use it to demonstrate math figures, write meaningful quotes, and practice memorizations, among other things. We actually installed the whiteboard before I got the maps, and that is what sparked the desire to find something to cover it. Yes, it is functional, but not exactly the art statement I was hoping to bring to the space. Now, before I tell you all about where we got the maps, let me first tell you about how we tried to DIY our own big rolling map. It was the biggest DIY fail we've probably ever had. So after our attempt, it was clearly only good for the dump. I have seen a lot of awesome and successful DIY map art projects on the web, and if you hope to create your own, I just want to be sure that you don't try what we did and waste your time and money. So that's why I'm going to share this with you. Now, I really wanted maps in here, so even after that failed, I ended up saving and buying these. But first, let's talk about what not to do. So I had the idea to buy a large map wallpaper, which was far more affordable than these canvas printed roll-down maps. Then I imagined applying the wallpaper to like a cheap vinyl rolling window shade. It seemed like a flawless idea, and we got started. Our biggest problem was finding a rolling window shade that was as big as our whiteboard and the wallpaper map that I had bought, and that's about 7 feet long. Well, those are very hard to find and very expensive, so we thought we could just join two cheap blinds, tape them down the center, and use a long wood dowel to join them together at the rolling mechanisms. Well, that seemed to work, so we started applying the wallpaper with wallpaper glue. It was a shifting, twisting, bubbling nightmare, to say the least. Once it dried, we thought, maybe it won't look so bad. Well, we got it on the wall, and it was clear our little makeshift, super large, joined together roller blind thingy was not going to work. It would sag, it would get stuck, the rollers would snap, and we gave up the map dream. Well, at least the hubs did. I kept looking for a solution and determined something that would be such a useful tool in my kids' educational experience was just worth buying. So I discovered this Etsy shop called Big World Maps, where they also go by Mondo Mappa. They have a huge selection of maps to choose from, and I was smitten. To top it off, they were able to customize the size I needed and allow me to layer more than one map. Now, I've even seen how they've layered up four maps for someone, which looked pretty cool. I will go ahead and leave a link in the description for you to the shop that I used for these maps, as you might enjoy seeing all the options they have. I do have a little word of warning. They have some vintage looking maps that I really, really loved, but at closer look, the names and labels were like in the language of the country or just really outdated and inaccurate. Where I wanted this to be an educational thing, it was important for me to find then one that would be a good reference and look beautiful. So the world map that I got, which I will also link below, is called the largest modern political world map, and the USA map is called large USA map. So both come in a variety of color options. Mondo Mappa gives you options for like the wood frame stain that you can customize. You can also opt for a hanging map instead of a rolling map, which is a little cheaper. So typically they send the wood that's above the map, but our order was so long that the wood shelf wouldn't fit into the containers. And I knew that if they would just send the hardware, we could easily make that shelf on our own. So that makes it still kind of a DIY project in my book. So I'm so pleased with the rich color of the print and the super high quality canvas that it's printed on. The rolling mechanisms work flawlessly, even with the weight and length of these large maps. I just know that these will last for a long time. Anyway, if you are looking for map art and I've scared you from the DIY option, check out these shops on Etsy. This post is not sponsored, but I wanted to be sure I created a reference for you if you are interested in learning more about our roll down classroom maps. Be sure to subscribe because I will be back soon to share the reveal of our entire homeschool space. Or if you're watching this later on, just check my channel or blog for that reveal. Now, if you haven't already watched my video on how I homeschool and work from home, you might enjoy that today. I also just posted all about our cabinets in here if you want to learn more about them. So feel free to stick around, see what else I have created that might be of interest to you. And then just stay in touch as I share more inspiration for do-it-yourself living, which apparently even includes a glimpse of the really bad do-it-yourself projects. Thanks for watching.